I'm Jackie, and we have Lauren and Susie with us here again today, and we are working on the pose Shavasana. So one of my favorite ones, actually, because this is the one that really allows people to get in touch with what they just did in their practice, how their body feels, and how they can completely relax and let go before they go back out the door into the real world. So in this posture, the idea is to actually relax everything. You've just worked hard in your practice, and now it's to tell every muscle in the body that you kind of want it to turn off and turn loose. So I usually encourage my students to kind of feel the feet relax, feel the hips relax, feel the shoulders relax. If they're not relaxing, then as a teacher, I'm gonna encourage you, get comfortable with touching your students, and I'm gonna show you how. Especially if you're not familiar with that yet or comfortable with it. Again, it's nice to ask your students if it's okay to touch them. Most of the time they're gonna say yes. You will get an occasional person that says no, and you respect that. But a lot of them like the little pampering and the little bit of adjustment. For Lauren, I'm actually gonna pick up her legs. The important thing for the student to do is not to squeeze their glutes, because if they squeeze and activate the low body, it's gonna hurt your back. So tell them to completely relax. You're gonna take your hands and grab their ankles. You'll pick them all the way up off the floor, and you want to ground and hunker down through your legs and engage your abdominals. Then you're gonna slightly pull back, pick them up, and wiggle their hips side to side. You might get a lot of play with some people and a little play with others. After you've jiggled them a little bit, you're gonna pull them all the way back down and lay their heels down, nice and soft, and then maybe pull across the top of the foot, which just adds to the pull down the entire front side of the leg. Now, she started out with the bolster. That's a great thing to add to put underneath the knees if you actually have pain in the back of the knees or in the low back. But she looks good like this, so I'm gonna go ahead and pull this bolster out to the side. She doesn't really need it. For Susie, I'm gonna have her bring her arms up over her head so that I can give her one last stretch in the shoulders. Take your hands, cup them into theirs, and ask them to hold on to you. Then, again, ground through your feet, bend your knees, suck in your stomach, and pull gently back. This is gonna separate their ribs from the hips. You don't have to wiggle, you're just pulling. And then when you let go, they usually let out a sigh, and then you allow their hands to float right back down into their Shavasana position. You guys feel okay?
Yep.
Okay, so another personal pampering that really seals the deal. It's almost like the closure to the class, and your students are gonna walk out and they're gonna love you. Shoulders, pressing down on shoulders. I usually do two times. So I'll take my hands, I'll tell the student, I'm gonna put them right here on the top edges of the shoulders. I'll tell them to take a deep breath in, and then you're pressing as they exhale. And then I'll say, breathe in again. My hands are gonna go onto the top of the shoulders, and on the exhale, I'm gonna push down. It helps their whole upper body, head, neck soften into the earth. I'm gonna do the same thing for Susie. So again, get your feet, you know, a little bit wider stance, bend the knees, engage your abdominals, hands on the shoulders, deep breath in, and then exhale, pressing down. And then we'll do it again, breathe in. And then exhale, pushing down. Okay. If you want to do anything else for your students, it's always nice sometimes to maybe take the thumbs, maybe roll them across the eyebrows, maybe down over the ears, maybe down into the neck. And again, you're just using a couple fingers. You don't really have to pull your whole hand in there. And just kind of pull gently across the back of the head, over the top part of the ear, and then come out. It's always good to shake off the person's energy or cut it completely before you touch the next person. That always comes in handy because you've got a lot of energy in the room. You don't really want to mix them when you're touching so many people. So just kind of disconnect or flick it off. You guys feel good? So once their body is completely relaxed, maybe walk them through maybe 10 seconds, maybe 10 minutes of like a nidra, where you're actually disconnecting their senses so that their body will relax even deeper. I usually say something like, maybe breathe in through the soles of your feet and imagine that water is coming in and moving like water up through the heels and through your ankles, up through the shins and calves, up to your knees, to your thighs, and then into your hips. So the entire lower body is completely relaxing and releasing into the floor, moving up through the spine, the whole spine relaxes, the shoulders, the elbows, the wrists, the fingers. No tension, just relaxation. Back of the head is comfortable, the back of the neck. Let your forehead soften, all the tiny muscles in the forehead, eyes relax in the sockets. Your mouth and jaw, no tension, totally relaxing. The whole body, turning loose and letting loose, the whole body. Feeling the movement of the breath as the belly rises and falls. Nowhere to go, nothing to do, just breathe. And then again, it's all up to them on when they get up. So, all right. Hope this helped you guys. Again, any questions or concerns, let me know. If you haven't watched the intro video just kind of explains why we're here and why we're doing this. So thanks again for coming. Bye.